made a statement. Said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And I believe that each one of us seated here this morning is glad to be here. Let me see by hand those of us here who are glad to be here. Oh, we give God a glory.
Amen.
The keyboardist, guitarist, and the drummer, please come over. Want to do one short song, and after that the word will come.
Amen.
I believe that God has something for you this morning. And you are not going to step out of this sanctuary the same.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know this song? The church's one foundation is Jesus Christ the Lord. Do you know it? Hallelujah. The church is one foundation. What key are you playing? F. Yeah, it's okay. Let's see. Hallelujah. You hum it. You keep playing. Thank you, Jesus. I want to give you the words and follow it before we sing. If you can put the words on the screen, that would be great. The church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. She is his new creation. By water and the word. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. Not a holy bride, but holy bride. Hallelujah. The question is, are you holy? Am I holy? Do we qualify to be the bride of Jesus? With his own blood, Christ bought the church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
With his own blood, he bought us. You know that? That you are not your own? There is a price tag on your head, and that is the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you don't want to mess that blood up, because once you mess it up, you do that at your own peril. The church is one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. She is his new creation. She is his new. By water and the blood, from heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride with his own blood. Life he elect from every nation, he elect from every name, yet one through all the earth, yet one through all the earth. A charter of salvation, a charter. One birth, one faith, one Lord, one holy name. She blesses, partakes one holy food And to one hope she presses with her. Christ in you, Christ in me is our hope of glory. And to that hope, every grace endued in us, we press. We press. Brother, keep pressing on. Sister, keep pressing on. For the world has nothing to offer you. The world has nothing to offer me. In the world, there is chaos. But with Jesus, there is peace. He said, in the world, you and I will face tribulation. But we must be of good cheer, for he has overcome the world. You are the right place. You are on the right side of life. Do not be deceived. This is what the Bible says. God is not mocked. Hallelujah. Well, for whatsoever a man soweth, that also he shall reap. If you sow to the flesh, you're going to reap corruption. But if you sow to the spirit, you will reap life everlasting. You see, I don't know if some of you sitting here know a place called Yomuasi. Who knows a place called Yomuasi? Yomuasi. W? You see, whether you know that there's a place called Yomuasi or not, it doesn't matter, but it exists. So it doesn't matter whether you know there's hell or heaven. Everything that has a name exists. In fact, nothing exists. Even nothing exists. God has no vacuum in life. You understand what I'm saying? Yes. A day is coming that Jehovah God is going to judge this world in righteousness. And he has appointed a man that we just sang about. The one who is the foundation of the church. His name is Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. And whether you believe it or not, I'm not here to argue with you, but I'm here to present this fact to you that he's going to judge you and me one day. Yes. And if you think it is hot when you turn on your air conditioner, when you go to hell, no air conditioner. You better think about that seriously. Because the Bible says that in hell, the fire there is burning with what? Sulfur and brimstone. What is the melting point of sulfur? The chemist should tell us. Something small, you are cooking, you tie the stove. Ash, that place, you'll be surprised. You don't want to mess with Jesus. Be always on the right side of life. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh unto the Father but by me. You know, the Lord visited us here on Friday in a unique way. But I believe today, I don't know what he's up to, but something is going to happen. You see, as we were worshiping, I felt led to go and give my brother Gaius a hug. And the moment I hugged him, you know, tears started flowing out. And then he placed his hand on my belly. Jesus. I don't know what that is, but something is going to happen. We are going to give birth to something. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Because God has his eye on Gateway Chapel International. More than you know. Amen. That is why the Lord God is challenging you and me about the fruit of righteousness. Because without that, the Bible says, without holiness, no man shall see God. True or false? True. Just as without faith, it is impossible to please God. You can't just walk into Walmart or the African market. Yes, Friday, you know, Pastor took me to an African market here in town. I loved it. Beautiful place. All the Ghanaian food was there. Really? And I told Pastor that if I bring my girls here, my wallet will be empty. They love those things. But you see, we couldn't have walked in there and picked anything and walked away. Shoplifting, they would arrest us. And you think you can come to the house of God and pick something without faith? So without faith, it is impossible to please him. And that anyone who comes to God must believe that he exists. And that he is the one who rewards those who diligently seek him. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. Hallelujah. The IT personnel, can you leave on the screen for us? The book of Job. Go to Job chapter 14 and leave on the screen for us from verses 7 through 9. La siboko sai. Have you seen that? We are coming to the word. But I want you to check this. This is going to be the preamble. You know, this morning, as I was speaking to Pastor Gales, you know, he made a statement that there is hope. And that was just a confirmation of what the Lord had laid on my heart as a preamble to the message today. Look at that. For there is hope of a tree if it is cut down, that it will sprout again. And that the tender branch thereof will not cease. Give us verse 8. Though the root thereof wax old in the earth, and the stalk thereof die in the ground. Kamo sikia. What is verse 9? Yet. Malokosobo. The Spirit of the Lord, who is here today, that scent of water is going to cause you to flourish again. So there is hope for your future. Let me tell you one thing. Regardless of what Satan is throwing at you, you are coming out victorious.
Amen.
Well, the Bible says that Jesus is building his church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against the church. And if you are a son of righteousness, the son will do what? Will rise with healing in his. We just read it. So, Mami read it for us here. The gates of hell will not prevail against you because of the Spirit of God upon, because of the anointing of the Lord upon your life. You see, as I was asking the Lord what he wants us to look at this morning, he gave me this small thing. Can you put on the screen for us Nehemiah chapter 4 and the verse 6? Nehemiah chapter 4 and the verse 6. You see, when Nehemiah went ahead to build, what had he gone to build? What had broken down? The walls of where? Jerusalem. There was success because the people had a mind to work. They were not lazy. The people had the mind to work. And regardless of what God has spoken to you and me in this place, if we don't have the mind to work, zero. Hallelujah. So the question is, do you have the mind to work with Jesus to make Gateway Chapel International what he intends for the church to look like? Then when the Lord gave me this, he said, thus saith the Lord. I wrote it down and I want to read it. The breaches in the walls have been closed. Breaches in the walls of your life brother, sister, they've been closed.
Amen.
And that is a fact. Something happened here on Friday. And what happened here on Friday, I want you to remember that it is the old era that is gone. A new era has come. The Lord has laid your foundations with sapphire. The Lord has laid your foundation with precious stones. In fact, your walls are ever before the Lord God Almighty, and your names are engraved in His power. He sees you every day. He is watching over you. In fact, the Bible says that the eye of the Lord moves to and fro throughout the whole earth, that He may do one thing. Can you tell me? Show Himself strong on behalf of those whose hearts are loyal to Him. If you are loyal to God, if your heart is loyal to God, I can assure you, God will show Himself strong on your behalf. Amen. Because this is His word. You know, the Bible is a book of propositions. It's like those of you who are scientists. Action and reaction, they are equal and opposite. Whatever you put in is what you get back. So if you put in a lukewarm attitude towards God, brother, sister, don't expect anything. But if you give God your all, you have everything. And no matter what Satan does, you will come out dancing, knowing that Jehovah is on your side. He has arisen as a mighty warrior on your behalf. And I know that Jesus has risen as a mighty warrior on behalf of Gateway Chapel International. The breaches in the walls are sealed.
Amen.
I tell you, there are no cracks in the walls anymore.
Amen.
If the devil comes in, if he sends his demons to come and lie to you, say, get behind me, Satan. The breaches have been sealed.
Amen.
There is a firewall around you. That's the Holy Ghost fire.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We are getting there.
Yes.
You see, this morning I want to encourage you to do a few things. To maintain the closed breaches in the walls solid. I want to encourage you and me to do a few things. And as we do those things will help you and me to be in compliance with God's divine order. For you and me, for this new era that we are in. Should we say compliance? Please say it with me. Compliance.
Compliance.
You and I must be in compliance to God's divine order for this new era that He set us in. And in order to do that, Mr. IT, sir, please, can you give us Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and the verse 8? Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and the verse 8. It's a very simple scripture. But how often do we overlook this? It said, let your garment always be white. What does white stand for?
Righteousness,
purity. And let your hair, although I don't have mine, God knows the number of the pores. Oh, yes. You see? The doctor is saying that, oh, you see, he raised his hand because he knows that God knows the number of hairs on his head,
yeah,
including mine.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Okay.
Let your garments be always white. If you want to be in compliance with God's divine order, for you to see His glory in this new era, let your garment always be white, and let your head lack no ointment. ointment there is the presence of God, Jehovah God on your life. The anointing upon your life. When the anointing is upon your life, no demon, no power of darkness, no evil force from your bloodline, whether it's from your father's line or from your mother's line, will prevail against you. Oh, have you forgotten what happened to the God of the Philistines? You know, Dagon or Dagon, whoever, whichever way you want to call it, Dagon, Dagon. But there is some gone somewhere, and there's some DA somewhere. Pardon me? Oh, no, it's okay, eh?
I said he's gone.
He's gone. Okay, praise the Lord. Oh, come, boy, say la baba. Wow, this is a revelation. He is gone. We give God a glory. We give God a glory. You see, the Philistines made a mistake. And they took the ark of Jehovah God and placed it in the same room as their God. Oh, man, something happened. Oh, hallelujah. They came the next time. Ah, what's happening to you now? No power. Okay. They lifted him, placed him there. They went to sleep. If they knew what was coming, they wouldn't have done that. They came the next day into pieces. And this is what God is going to do. If Satan, if demons, the witches and wizards from our families, from our circle of friends, from our place of work, from our neighborhood, from our city, if they make any attempt at us because of the anointing upon our life, they will be like Dagon. They'll be long gone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you first must understand what it means to be there so that the anointing will be maintained. Your garment must always be white, and your hair should not lack any ointment. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, when I had a shower this morning, if I hadn't placed some hair food or that I don't have hair on my scalp, you will see patches of white, correct? It's dry. But when you oil your head, oh, glory. Yes, sir. Oh, lako torobosaya. As I'm standing, I can see the reflection on the forehead of Dr. Asari. And I'm sure you are seeing mine, right? You know, the tree will say a shrine, you know. The instruments will say Olecta. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now this is fireworks, I tell you. Ekwe. Oh wow. God is good. You see, you and I must learn to maintain our garments. And you know, today, we're going to do a certain type of prayer. But once we get there, you know what it is. But let us put it to the back of our minds. The Gateway Chapel, if you want to see what God started here on Friday, right here on this floor, in this room, in this sanctuary, so that you are able to move from here to that new place that we don't know, but God knows that location, and God knows the size of that sanctuary. That God appointed some people here on Friday to be the financiers of that. And if I remember, my brother sitting there at the back, people say he looks like me. God appointed him on Friday here. He's going to be the ringleader of that group of people.
Amen.
And listen to this. If we want to get there and overflow our limits, our boundaries, then we must learn to live in righteousness. And we must maintain the anointing. Oh, the presence of God makes the difference. Yes. You know, when Saul was anointed by Samuel, he came out from that place and he met the prophets. What came upon him? The spirit of prophecy came upon him. He became a different man. He began to prophesy. You see, when the presence of the Lord is upon you, you are a different man. I tell you, you are a different beast. No one can mess with you. It's all because of the presence. But you see, if the presence is not there, forget it. You know, like the Zambians, you know, the Bembas or the Nyanjas will say, Kulibe so. Kulibe means nothing. Yeah, Kulibe. And they will add so. It means nothing so, you know. The losers will say, Akuna. Nothing. Eh? Akuna butata is me no problem. You know, hallelujah. Now we are speaking the tongues of men, so at least we can interpret, you know. And if we go off, we have our brother here, you know, Pastor Katai. No, he's from Zambia. You know, this is a man, before I continue with the word, that God linked me up with in 1989 when I was in Zambia as an expatriate teacher. He was young, from Bible school, fire in his belly, and walking on springs, you know, of the Holy Ghost. He came to Salanga with a mission, and God linked us up, and the rest is history. Amen. I know his giftings, because I worked with him. He flows in the area of deliverance. I mean, look, God has touched life through this man. Amen. And today, the Lord will employ his ministry with us here. Amen. When we started communicating around 2009 or 8, you know, I didn't know I was going to meet him. And then we've been praying together on the phone almost every night. In fact, the month of February, the Lord said, you guys must pray. And we kept praying. And I said, but Pastor, you know, Ba means like, you know, Mr. Buona, you know, respect for. I said, but Pastor, we'll be meeting in North Carolina shortly after many years. When I saw him, this morning, just gave me a hug. I said, Pastor, can you recognize his head? There was head there one way in Senanga, you know, now it's all. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let your garments always be white. And let your head ointment. Keep that one. Point number two. Something that you and I want to do to continue to be in compliance, prayer. Can you please take us to Nehemiah chapter 4, verses 7 through 9? Of course, we have read that, correct? Good. Now, let's go back. Yeah, let's go back there. Let's go back there. Yes. It came to pass that when Sanballat and Tobiah and the Arabians and the Ammonites and the Ashdodites heard that the walls of Jerusalem were made up, oh, people are going to hear that the breaches in the walls are sealed. They are going to hear it, and they will see it. Now, what happened? What happened? They got angry and began to what? Pardon me? They conspired. What? Why were they conspiring? They were coming together to do one thing, to fight against Jerusalem and to hinder it. You see, when the enemy sees that the breaches in your walls are sealed and that God is blessing Gateway Church Chapel, they'll conspire to come against you. But that is futile. It's a futile effort. Let's go to the next verse. Haleboko, listen to that. Nevertheless, we made our prayer unto our God and set a watch against them day and night. Oh, that is why Pastor and Associate Pastor Dr. Jesse and all the leaders here, Dr. Sari, all the leaders of this church, you have to open your eyes and be alert and vigilant. Because a time is coming that wolf may come in sheep clothes. Mark this. And they are not coming to play games. First, they are coming to attack. They will start from the head. They will play games. If they don't get him, then they will go and look at, you know, dog. They try, they don't get, they come to you. So they will try. But you see, if these men who are standing in the gap on behalf of the flock, if they are fire, their eyes are open, and they are in prayer, victory is yours. Amen. Nevertheless, we made our prayer unto our God and set watch against them day and night because of them. Don't give your eyes sleep. Now, leaders of the church, listen to this. I know that from this day forward, God is going to wake you up at all times in the night. Don't pull the blanket over your head. Wake up and go to the floor. If you need to go into the shower and pour cold water on you, pour cold water and come and do battle against the kingdom of darkness. Amen. You have to pray as never before. Because the enemy is not kind and is not gentle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have to pray day and night. Again, as you maintain your garments white always and your head lacking no oil, you want to soak yourself in prayer. The Bible says, whatsoever you and I will bind on earth to be bound in heaven. And that is true. And whatever will loosen on earth will be loosened in heaven. And that is true. I was sharing a story with Pastor Gaius yesterday about one of our brothers at Tech, you know, Martin Metrivi from the Volta region. He said he once went home. At that time, he was even in high school, maybe in sixth form before he came to campus at Tech. And then he went to the Volta region and went to the beach. And there was this fetish priest performing some rituals. So they were playing the drums and the fetish priest was dancing. So he stood there, young man, in the scripture union. He said, Brother David, he used to call me Rabboni. That was like my nickname, you know. He said, Rabboni, you know what? I will stand there and then clench my teeth and say, I'm binding Jesus' name. And then the man will be standing. You couldn't move. They are playing the drums. Then he will loosen and the robot will be going, I bind you. So you were going back and forth. High school boy in sixth form, but he was committed. The brother loves the Lord. He said, I stood there watching this man. I was just binding him and loosen. So it's like robot, remote control. And that is the way you have to do.
Amen.
We had one man, listen to this. He was our head porter at Queen's Hall. His name is Mr. Akpabli from the Volta region. There was one boy in social sciences, if you remember, his name is Abins from Achimota. Abins messed up with Mr. Akpabli. You know, Mr. Akpabli was so angry that you know what he told Abins? You, this boy, I will summon you in the bush and you receive the answer under your bed.
Wow.
The man was not joking. I said, I'm going to summon you in the bush. You see your room? I know where your room is because I'm the head porter here. You receive the answer under your bed. And the man was not joking. You don't joke with Satan. People send out curses. You are here in the United States, North Carolina, Raleigh. You think you are far away from, you know,
Gombo abrofedo. You are not far. In the spirit realm, there's no distance. You are here. Oh, Eija is far from here. Nalai. Omale. Omale. Ampa. Ubwa. We are truthful. In the spirit realm, there's no distance. If you're not careful, they'll connect you. You see, like mathematics, you are doing to that priest, fetish priest on the beach. They are there, remote control. You are here in Raleigh. Whatever you do is in chaos. Because they are operating you. There's an altar they built for you. And you are going to destroy those altars. But they are gone. They are British in your war. They are sealed. Maintain your righteousness. Maintain your anointing. And pray without ceasing. That's how you hit fire on their head. See, they started disturbing me and my family. Man, when they do that, I go wild. You know, my wife cooks very nice food. And if she cooks, you don't eat, she's very disturbed. I said, Mama, don't worry. This one, this body is like the sea, you know, high tide, low tide. When the time comes for me to eat, I will eat. I'll chop. But this one, please, you give me cocoa sakura. Give me porridge without milk. Or sugar, just give me cocoa sakura. That's all I need. I come from work, my eyes are red. I fire a bit, I deck my cocoa sakura, I go to bed on the floor, I'm crying to the Lord. And results are happening. Amen. You have the power. I have the power. We need to be able to use it. If we don't, we do that at our own peril. Fidel, the guy who plays the guitar, he's got a lethal weapon as a soldier. It is up to him to know how to use that firearm. If he is not using it, a small boy with a catapult can easily destroy his eye. But if you have that AK-47, you open fire, boom, everybody will be taking cover, correct? Don't let Satan mess around you. Don't let his demons mess you around. Don't let the witches and wizards from your family and circle friends mess you up. Hold your feet to the fire every day by prayer. Pray for this congregation. Pray for pastor. Pray for his wife. Pray for the elders of this church. Pray for their families. Jehovah God will bring power into this place. And you see, as you pray for pastor, you pray for his wife, you pray for his children, you pray for the leaders, you are praying for your wife, you are praying for your children, you are praying for your family, your household will prosper. Amen. Some of us, our prayer is so self-centered. God, you know, that pair of shoes I saw there, God gave it to me. Oh, that car. Oh, I saw some beautiful suit at Kohl's. Don't worry. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness. Your garments being white. And all these things shall be added. This is Jesus speaking here. You see, we misplace our priorities. I was once ministering, and right there and then, the Lord dropped this in my spirit, and I wrote it down. The key that opens, this is what the Lord told me, I'm telling you. You can write it down and check it out from Scripture. Said the key that opens to God's storehouse of abundance is faith in the hand of righteousness. Hallelujah. Faith in the hand of righteousness. You see, faith is not for the unrighteous. The Bible says that the foundation of God stands sure with this inscription on it, that God knows those who are his, and that let anyone who names the name of the Lord depart from iniquity. Period. So the key that opens to the storehouse of God, which God has given you to begin to open and tap into it and begin to bless this church is faith in the hands of righteousness. That's why, you see, Pastor was talking about it here. He said, doesn't know why God is leading him to say that. God, because God wants to do something. God is saying that some of us sitting here must strengthen our lives with him. The things that we're doing secretly and nobody sees, God sees. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, you are married. You see somebody's wife and your head is going like this. Come on, wake up.
Amen.
You don't do that.
Yeah.
High school boy, you see that girl going and then you're like a robot. No, don't do that. Don't. Stop it. It's not of God. It's the last of the flesh, the last of the eyes. And some of us, it's just arrogance, pride. We can't shake it off. Let it go. And some of us sitting here, we must begin to lay aside food more. We always travel with our stomach. We can't leave our stomach behind. When it is noon, oh, the butterflies are flying in our stomach. We have to go and look for the food. Eh? Abinchi. Before pleasure. This one, pleasure before Abinchi. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So some of us sitting here, you know yourself. I don't know who you are. But the Lord God Almighty, Jehovah, wants us to straighten our lives. He's watching you. He knows you. Pastor may not see you. Maybe you might try to pull a fast one on pastor. Maybe you might have some discernment here and there. But you know yourself. Please stop that. Righteousness exalts a nation. But sin is a reproach. For people. If you want to see God, the power of God in your life, walk that path of righteousness. So we've spoken about prayer, right? Hallelujah. We are getting there. Don't worry. How many of us here love the word? Oh, thank you, Jesus. Beautiful. In fact, I'll be surprised if you didn't. Because I know your pastor loves the word, you know. You know, when Brageos and the others from Cavero Doses were on campus at Tech, I mean, anytime you saw them, you saw the word in action, the word in motion. Everything they said was the word. They wanted to know God and also make people know God through them. So they live by the word and prayer. And most of them today, they are servants of the Most High God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, Paul told young Timothy something. 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 15. 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 15. The word. Ha ha ha. What is it? Study to show thyself approved unto God. Child of God, please study. Study the word. Be a student of the word. Feed on it day and night. Study to show yourself approved unto God. A workman that needed to be ashamed. Rightly doing what? Dividing the word of truth. Thy word is truth. Hallelujah. The word of God is true. The word of God is life. The word of God is everything. It's all that we need. Because God has exalted his word above all his names. And one of the ways that you can do effective battle, the Bible says that the effectual fervent prayer for a righteous man availeth much. It doesn't avail much because you are David. It availeth much because of the fire of the word coming out of a belly which is sanctified, a life that is sanctified. So when you speak the word, it comes out as fire against the enemy.
Amen.
You see, before Jesus started his ministry, he went to the wilderness, 40 days, 40 nights, no food, no water, nothing. The man came out, the God man, he came out hungry. And Satan knew that. How would he say in Gam, are you hungry? You see, did Jesus say, Did he say that? When he came to Jesus and he tempted, because he knew that man was hungry. You call yourself the Son of God? Okay. If you're truly the Son of God, have you seen those stones? Turn them into bread. That was easy for Jesus to do. But what did he say? Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that cometh out of the mouth of God. You and I must be students of the word. We have to study the word and know it. In fact, we have to internalize scripture. Because in every situation of adversity, I can assure you, the Holy Ghost will put the right scripture in your spirit and encourage you. Amen. If you lack it, Satan will play you like FIFA football. Boom, there you are hanging there. Boom, you are just flying around over rally. Instead of you maintaining your feet, they are kicking you like football, and you don't know what's happening. You are so tired, you come here, they kick you. You are just running around. You are not steady. You have to study to show yourself approved unto God. A workman who is not ashamed, rightly doing what? Dividing. When pastor calls you to come and stand and teach the word, you release it. You know, when Dr. Sari was here leading the worship, then you go in tongues, and you could see that scripture is at work here. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, God bless you, sir. I mean, this man is educated. No, nobody can dispute that. You know, as you are sitting there, he's looking at you, he sees what is inside of you. He can see, if you're hungry, he can see how your stomach is, you know, contracting and expanding. He's got eyes that we don't have. And if he takes a knife now, he'll open us like a bird, you know. But he just cut us through, you know. But the man is so humble. Friday, if you were here, he was just in his jeans and his shirt, you know, jumping around and just having fun in God's presence. Doctor. Hey, Nyamiba, truly, God's son, truly, a group of people went to United Nations headquarters in New York, and they were looking for somebody. Let me give a scenario. Say, I'm going to look for, you know, Pastor Gaius. And then I get there, and I meet, you know, these two brothers here, nicely dressed, you know, diplomats, their reading glasses, eyes shiny, because every day they have to put things on their eyes for their eyes to shine, look very proper. And then I said, excuse me, sir. Do you know Pastor Gaius? I'm looking for him. And then one of the diplomat students said, what do you mean? Do you know who I am? So the people said, hey, we are in trouble here. We don't know what we are. He doesn't know who he is. Let's go and look. You got a scenario here? Do you know who I am? You see, you are lost. You want direction. You are seeking. They said, do you know who I am? Leave him and go. Hey, brother, please put 2 Timothy 3. Why is that? You don't know where you're going. Also, name who he is. That's confusion. Do you know who I am? We don't know. We are lost. We want the way. That's all we need. This know also that in the last days, perilous times shall come. And we're in the last days. Continue, brother. For men shall be lovers of their own selves. Who say, your brother is in need. Give him that dollar. You are holding on to it. You are holding. You see, you know, pastors can't need gas. Go fill it. When I was in South Africa, there was a guy who was the pastor of the church, the Assemblies of God pastor. He was living in Grahamstown, you know, in the Eastern Cape, where Road to University is. And he drove through the mountains every Sunday. So the Lord just laid on my heart, don't tell nobody. But if this guy comes every Sunday before he goes by, fill his tank for him. I said, yes, sir. I started doing it, and he didn't know what, you know. And I did it until I could do it. But you see, I could have kept those runs in my wallet, correct? Listen to this. A giving hand is always on top. Bible says, give, and you shall receive. That is the wisdom of God. The world says, hoard, and you get more. That's a lie. Don't follow it as a child of God. Give, and you shall receive. See, men shall be lovers of themselves, covetous. And if you see somebody wearing some clothes, you want it. You see pastor driving Lexus, you also want Lexus. Wake up now. That's covetousness. Boasters, you know, like peacock. Do you know who I am? Proud, blasphemous, disobedient to parents. Oh, I believe that a kid say you're obedient to parents. Please try. Unthankful, unholy. Oh, you want God to do something? Holiness. Let's go to the next verse. Without natural affection, truce breakers, they break peace. False accuser, they will accuse you. Something I don't know of. And last Friday here, God changed identities because some of us here have been labeled with a certain identity and the Lord delivered us. Amen. False accusers, incontinent, they are never satisfied. Greed, gluttony, fierce, they are wild. Despisers of those that are good, you and me. Let's go to the next verse. They are traitors, they are heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasure, more than lovers of God. As we are seeking to love Jesus, they are loving the bars, the discotheques, the prostitutes in the street corners. In 2000, I came from South Africa to the U.S. for 3 months. On my way back, I stopped in Atlanta for 2 weeks to visit my sister and some boys I taught in high school. One of them was a taxi driver, so he came and said, "Sir, I want to take you out and show you Georgia, Atlanta." I said, "No problem." And they came and took me in the night, and I should have slept, but no, close to between 11 and midnight, they took me. We went somewhere downtown. My head spinned. In fact, I didn't know that those people who came to the car were men. I thought they were women. They were men, and their bust was even bigger than women. And they were on these, you know, high heels. You know, their shapes and their hair. I thought they were women. I didn't even recognize nothing. But something strange happened. And I'm not lying. Listen to this. I was sitting in the front seat. None of them spoke to me. When they came to the car, the taxi, they spoke to those at the back. And I didn't understand until as we were going, my student was laughing. I said, "What is going on?" Said, "Did you know those people?" I said, "Oh, I don't know, but I saw them. No, these are women, these are prostitutes." "These are not women, these are men. Men who have changed themselves, you know, to women, with breasts even, excuse me to say, larger than the breasts of women. No, with their hips bigger on hormones, and their hair long on high heels." I'm not kidding you. In fact, when the guy told me that, the whole time we're driving, I kept thinking, I almost said, "Can you take me back? I want to look at them closely." But I really want to, are you serious? Oh, honestly, I mean, I've never seen this before. I mean, Johnny just come now. From Africa, me, I don't see these things. He said, "Sir, those are men." I said, "No, you must be kidding me, sir." "This is America." I said, "Wow." Male prostitutes who are like, and unfortunately, some men of God, so-called men of God, go after such men who have changed themselves into women to have, you know, connect sex with them. And they come and stand on the pulpit and they preach. I mean, you know what I'm talking about. It happened right here in America. I'm not going to mention names and the state, but you know. Sir, can we go to the next verse? Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, From such, do what? Turn away. My brother, don't go and break bread with them. Scriptures, turn away, move away from them. They'll mess you up. You know, transference of spirit? Cut away from them. Don't get yourself into a toxic environment. Look for an environment that is spiritually pure. Don't go to church where they'll tell you what to do. I used to preach in a church. I was an interim pastor there for 4 years. Hey, that was a Baptist church. You know, and me, a small man, at least I've got a bit of fire there, you know, Holy Ghost fire that at times I can't run away from. So at times I'll be in the pulpit and then tongues will come. You know, Baptists, they want you to speak of tongues. Like, hey. They want somebody will come to church and his whole clothes is full of, you know, smoke, tobacco, alcohol. I once went to preach in a town. I stood in for a pastor. You know what happened? Thank you, my brother. You see, they could see the reflection. This is like a mirage. You chase that water, it's not there. You see, soon after I finished preaching, I went to the parking lot to get into my car to drive away. I'd driven about 2 hours to that place to preach. I was still a graduate student. Right there, one of the guys, I'm sure he's one of the leaders there. Oh, right there in front of the church, the man pulled out a stick of tobacco and started smoking right in the parking lot. Oh, my brother, my sister, don't get near these people. You want to warn them. If they'll not take it, leave them in God's hands. From such, turn away. We are coming to the end. These are perilous times. But see, God has set you apart for a time like this. Amen. God wants to use you to touch people. But first, you must learn to maintain your purity and learn to maintain your anointing and learn to do battle in prayer. Pull down the kingdom of darkness. Amen. Don't be afraid of Satan. You see some small cop badged standing on the highway. A semi, an 18-wheeler. Sees this car badge with his hand raised. Will he run over him? No way, it's not going to happen. But you and me, let's go and try. We'll be dead bodies. They'll run over us until we are nothing. You see, there's so much power. The Bible says in the book of Ephesians that there's an immeasurable greatness of God's power towards us who have believed. Unleash that power in you against the kingdom of darkness. You are sitting there and the Satan is just playing around you. And why you're mobile, you are so sad. Come on, arise. You are not being arrogant. You are exercising your spiritual right and authority over kingdom of death. The Bible says that we are not fighting against flesh and blood. Those are demon, wicked spirits. They'll cause confusion in your life if you're not careful. We are coming to the end. So after you've studied the word, you know, you can write these things down and then when you go home, look at it. Psalm 119, verse 91. Psalm 119, verse 9, verse 11, 89, 103, 105, and 165. You know, the whole of Psalm 119 is the longest psalm, right? Read it. But check this out. He speaks about the word. How can a young man keep his way pure? That word have I hid my heart, that I will not sin against you. That word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. The word of God, the word of God is so important and vital. Most of us, the only time we carry a Bible and open is when we come to church. Don't do that, please. Don't do that. If you are to resist the devil and live above sin, you know, I have to learn how to do battle. And as you do that, finally, let us look at Jeremiah chapter 31 and the verse 14. Jeremiah chapter 31 and the verse 14.
Have you heard? As you are living in righteousness, and as you are battling, studying the word and praying for your pastor, praying for the pastor's wife, and I will satiate the soul of the priest with fatness. This man will be blessed. Amen. His wife will be blessed. Amen. And so would you be. Amen. And my people shall be satisfied with my goodness, saith the Lord. Amen. Take off him. God will take off you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not saying that when you get your paycheck, go and give it to Pastor Gates. This is not what we are saying. But you see, God is going to open your eyes to see things. God is going to open your ears to hear things. Act as led by the Spirit of God.
Amen.
If you come to church and God says, you know, go and give the pastor, you know, a $10 bill and an envelope. Go and give it. You may never know how that will bless him. And as you do that, you'll be blessed.
Amen.
Let us look at verses 16 and 17, sir, of the same Jeremiah 31. And as you do this, thus said the Lord. Hallelujah. I like that. Thus said the Lord. Refrain your voice from weeping and your eyes from tears. Why? Thy works shall be rewarded. Nothing that is sown in the kingdom of God is in vain. I can assure you. God will bless you. See, God is faithful. That I can say. He is faithful, even when we are not. And he said, say the Lord, and they shall come again from the land of the enemy. You remember what the Lord gave us here Friday night from Isaiah chapter 45? He said, he will give us the treasures of darkness and the hidden world of secret places, so I will know that it is him who has called us by name. Amen.
Amen.
This is the God we serve.
Refrain
your voice from weeping and your eyes from tears, for thy work shall be rewarded. The work that you do here, it shall be rewarded.
Amen.
Your labor in prayer and fasting for pastor and his wife and for the leaders of the church, for that young girl in there, for that woman, for that man in the congregation, you are doing that nobody is seeing. God will reward you openly.
Amen.
God will begin to cause this church to flourish like a palm tree and begin to grow like the cedars of Lebanon. And people say, what is happening at Gateway Chapel International? Holy Ghost.
Touch his family, oh Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, our Lord, we magnify you, oh God. Thank you, Father, for peace and joy and rest. Thank you, Father, that you have surrounded him, oh God, the same way you surrounded Job. The Lord is saying, fear not. What you have and what you are, no power of darkness will destroy.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are going to dwell in peace.
Amen.
Don't let that spirit of fear torment you. Everything that concerns you, your family, your children, your finances, is in secure hands.
Amen.
The Lord has protected you. Fear not. Let fear not cross your mind in the day or in the night. The Lord has surrounded you. The Lord is your war. And that war, as the man of God said, is sealed. It will never be broken. God bless you, my brother. We thank you, King of kings and Lord of lords. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, Father, for the power of healing and for the power of deliverance. And again, I sense like there is something that you are thinking about, or maybe something that crossed your mind, something in the family lines, something in the bloodlines that should not cross your mind no more. The Lord has set you free from that. There's a new name because you are born again. Out of the incorruptible seed, the blood that is in you is the bloodline of Christ Jesus our Lord. Even as we take communion today, claim that new bloodline in you. Don't identify yourself from the former bloodline, says the Lord. Identify yourself from the new bloodline in Christ Jesus. And everything in Christ Jesus is new. So fear not their fear. Fear not what kills them. Fear not what destroys them. Fear not what impoverishes them. Because everything in you is new. And the Lord is saying, behold the new. Meaning all the time, think of the new that is in you and in Christ Jesus. As you abide on the newness, as you abide on the newness, the old will pass away. And I thank you, Father, for the power of the renewed mind.
Hallelujah.
That your servant indeed, as he reads the word of God, his mind will be renewed and identify himself as a new creation in you. In the mighty name of Jesus, our Lord and our Savior, we pray with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Amen.
Shall we give Jesus a kiss? You know, we are coming to the end. I know time. You know, but we're in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
I want God to have his way. We're going to end soon. But please bear with us a bit. We'll be done shortly.
Amen.
You know what? Can you please put Zechariah chapter 3? You know, as Pastor and Pastor Katai were ministering, you know, hallelujah.
Amen.
Pastor, do you remember what happened at breakfast table yesterday in your house? Brother Fidel was asking about what is purpose. And when Pastor Kata was praying, this man, he lives somewhere. He doesn't live in Raleigh. We gave him the direction to this place, and he drove here this morning. When I was praying for Fidel and his wife, the Lord led him to pray about purpose to be fulfilled in the life of this young man and the wife. The Lord is good. And as he was praying, you know, especially the last time here, the Lord led me to Zechariah chapter 3. And I want us to, there is a message there. You remember when Joshua the priest was being resisted by Satan, the Lord released a command. And you know, the families that we prayed for, that is the call, right? The same blessing is upon everyone in this body.
Amen.
But these families are key. Right? That's why today the Lord led us to pray for them. And you will see the results. Because Jehovah does not lie. The Bible says he's not a man that should lie. He's not a son of man that should repent. As he said, and will he not do it? Numbers, right? And families that have been prayed for, there shall be no enchantment against you.
Amen.
No power of witchcraft will ever come near your tent.
Amen.
Because of the fire of the Holy Ghost. Now, Pastor Gaius, please lead us to read these. Let Pastor Gaius lead us.
And that was
Zechariah
chapter 3. And the verse 1. And he showed me, Joshua, the high priest, standing before the angel of the Lord, and Satan standing at his right hand to resist him.
Verse 2.
And the Lord said unto Satan, the Lord rebuke thee, O Satan. Even the Lord that has chosen Jerusalem rebuke thee. Is not this a brand plucked out of the fire? Now Joshua was clothed with filthy garments and stood before the angel. And he answered and spake unto those that stood before him, saying, take away the filthy garments from
this
him.
This is what God has done to you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Sister, please mark the sure word of prophecy. The Lord led the man of God to speak into your life. And many of you here, please mark the show of prophecy. Pastor, continue.
And unto him he said, behold, I have caused thine iniquity to pass from thee.
Amen.
And I will clothe thee with change of raiment.
Pastor, please hold on to this, okay? Spirit of God, take us to... You remember the 2 Kings?
Chapter 30, verse 25.
Correct.
No, chapter 25, verse 30.
Correct. But you know, we are going to 2 Kings. We are going to read from, let me get my reading glasses. You know, the eyes are getting a bit tired. You know, in Zambia, we say, you know, Bamudala. Okay, let's go to 2 Kings, okay? There is something there that we need to mark. We're going to mark the sure word of prophecy, brothers and sisters. Okay, 2 Kings chapter 25. Let us start from verse 27. And Pastor, again, continue. We'll come back to Zechariah, but please, Pastor, read for us.
And it came to pass in the 7th and 30th year of the captivity of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, in the 12th month, on the 7th and 20th day of the month, that evil Merodach, king of Babylon, in the year that he began to reign, did lift up the head of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, out of prison.
Yes, sir.
And he spake kindly to him, and set his throne above the throne of the kings that were with him in Babylon, and changed his prison garments, and he did eat bread continually before him all the days of his life. And his allowance was a continual allowance, giving him of the king a daily rate for every day. All the days.
Gateway Chapel International. You will not lack.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God.
Your heads have been lifted by Jehovah God.
Ah.
Your prison garments have been removed. The filthy garments, they have been removed.
Amen.
Spiritually, in fact, when Pastor was praying for this man, you know what I saw in the spirit realm? A statue of gold. This man is gold sitting here.
Ah! Shikebo, Rabahatan, Narabahaboshi.
This man, as you have been prayed for here, it's like this will be removed from here. And I saw this gold, and like
the oil around is looking so shiny. Oh, Gateway Chapel, do you know what you have?
Hey.
In fact, you know, pray that God brings me from Iowa to. I want to see what's happening here. So that I don't walk in snow 2 feet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to see what God is going to do with Sophie Mami and Sophie Gayle, see her with all of you. Daily allowance for the rest of his life. Oh, this man. God has blessed him. And you, he's blessed because you are blessed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ah, Onupa, boss, please take us to Zechariah chapter 3. Let's finish it, and I'll hand over to Pastor. Then we will do whatever, you know. We were right. Go to the verse 5. Right. Ah, here we are. Osofo.
And I said, let him set a fair meter upon his head. So they set a fair meter upon his head and clothed him with garments. And the angel of the Lord stood by. And the angel of the Lord protested unto Joshua, saying, thus says the Lord of hosts.
Please listen to this, right?
If thou wilt walk in my ways, and if thou wilt keep my charge, then thou shalt also judge my house. And shall also keep my courts, and I will give thee places to walk among these that stand by.
Shall we stand? Let's stand to our feet. Give us. I'm going to sing a song. If you know how to sing it, sing with me. Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus. Just to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise, just to know thus says the Lord.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, now instrumentalists, stop playing. Come here, let's pray for you. Sir, please come. All the instrumentalists, come. It's okay. No music now. Come. Osofo. Doc. Doc JC and Doc Asari, please come. Take one of them. Pastor Katai. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, you are four, right? Take one each. Lay hands and minister to these people. So when they touch the instruments, how I proved him over and over.
May the Spirit of God,
Jesus, precious Jesus,
to play this instrument.
Oh, for grace to trust him.
With joy, trust him. And with the anointing to bless, that the blessing of God shall come down on this house to transform lives. In the name of Jesus, may this gift in you never die. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, receive fresh oil, fresh anointing for this assignment, for this purpose. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you, Lord.
Jonah, come and stand here, please. Come and stand here. You know, it's interesting how God moves, you know, because during the worship session this morning, the Lord kind of laid on my heart to pray for you, to anoint you. But I kind of just discarded it, you know. I felt like it was just my mind, you know. But the Spirit of God is going to come upon you. You're going to play this drum in this house, and the heavens will open.
Amen.
Amen. You know, I'm going to soil your dress, but you know it's okay because this is just obedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Stretch your hands toward Him in the name of Jesus, Father. This oil is symbolizing that anointing that came upon your servants of old, such as David, who was so anointed that when he played the instruments, yes, demons came out of people.
Amen.
Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that even as I anoint him, may the power of your presence come all over him. That as he plays the sound of the drums, oh God, the heavens shall open. Amen. In the name of Jesus, anoint his hands, anoint his spirit, anoint his ears, anoint his eyes. Give him, Lord, a special grace for this assignment. In the name of Jesus Christ. Rabahabo shikebren neleri bahandala baba rabahande shikebre talababa rabahabo shikebe talababa rabahabo shikelebebe rabahanda rabahade shikibro shikibre talababa rabahadan tarabahabo shakalabadara badara baba rabahandara baba rabahandara baba labaya rabashin eri asiba tarababaya rabahabaya. You will fulfill the purpose of God. You will fulfill the purpose of God. You will fulfill the purpose of God in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We shall take the communion. Can you put on the board for me Hebrews chapter 10, verse 9? Thank you. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 9, as I meditated on doing communion this morning, there's the word of the Lord that came to me. You know, something happened in my home last night. Pastor is there with us. And his name is Castro. I said Castro. Fidel and Lita were with us. So last night, all of a sudden, I heard some music being played. It was a Ghanaian song, Worship Medley. And I was wondering, who is playing this music in the house? And Fidel says, him. I said, wow. You Togolese, you are playing Ghanaian worship songs. But there was a presence of God that just came all over the house. Amen. And as we listened to the songs, something developed. There was a rise in emotion, all of us. And then we started to pray. Long story short, we prayed for about 3 hours in the house, just speaking in tongues. God revealed some things to me, which one of it has been confirmed this morning during the service when he was preaching. I tell you, something is about to happen in this church.
Amen.
Something is about to happen in this church. What happened last night, I have experienced it before. That is why I'm saying so. I've experienced it before. It's like a wave that comes. And I thank God for bringing the servant David. God wants to set our house in order.
Yes. Amen.
Let us run away from sin and evil. Okay? Let us be different from the people of the world, because God is about to do, and he wants to bless vessels that are holy, that have their white garments on. I was very blessed last Friday. The attendance to the all-night meeting, it was very well patronized. God bless you. But God is about to do something. Hallelujah. Now watch this scripture. Then said he, that is Jesus, lo, I come to do thy will. In other words, there's a certain purpose, something in the heart of God that he wants to be done. And there was nobody else who could do it except Jesus. Hallelujah. So he came to execute that assignment, that purpose. That is why he says that, "Behold, I come to do thy will." That is the will of the Father, O God. When he said that, he says, "He taketh away the first, that he may establish the second." In other words, there was something that was already hovering over the human race. There was a condition of failure and defeat, inappropriateness, sickness and disease and wickedness that existed over your life and my life, that kept us in prison. And when Jesus came, he came to set aside this old order in order to establish a new. Hallelujah. Verse 10. By the which will. Remember, the verse before talk about the will of God. So by that same will, we are sanctified, chosen, selected, set apart. Through the offering of the body. The body of Jesus. We have been set aside. When you take this breath this morning, you are participating with divinity. And that sets you apart. Hallelujah. Through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ, once for all. Verse 11. And every priest standeth daily ministering and offering oftentimes the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. Can you imagine? In the Old Testament, the priests were offering sacrifices again and again, but it was never able to take away their sins. It just covered it. You know how you can have some dirty clothes and put it in a basket somewhere and you cover it? The outside may look nice, but the dirty clothes is still there. And when you open it, the stench will come. Hallelujah. But when Jesus came, he brought about change. He cleaned not only the outside, but the inside. Oh, God is doing something new here. Hallelujah. Verse 12. But this man, are you not glad that Jesus is being referred to as a man? This man, Jesus, after he had offered one, not many, but one sacrifice, just one sacrifice, for sins forever, he sat down at the right hand of God. 13. From henceforth, expecting till his enemies be made his footstool. 14. For by one offering he has perfected forever them that are sanctified. By one offering he has perfected. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this body of Christ that we are about to partake of, and the blood of Jesus that was shed for us. By faith, O God, we are stepping into your presence through the blood of the everlasting covenant. And we are saying and calling upon heaven to come and take care of our lives. Let broken lives, oh God, be healed today. Let there be healing of the mind, healing of the body, healing
of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Let curses, oh God, be broken because of the blood of Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you for divine health. Thank you for prosperity. Thank you, God, that we shall flourish like the palm tree. Thank you, God, for riches. Thank you for honor. Thank you for grace. Thank you for mercy. As we take this bread, we thank you. As we take this wine, we thank you. Bless it, because we are your children. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.